It started off, they were using Aboriginals as slaves, it was called blackbirding, and they were taken out to sea, and if they dived down and they didn't come up with an oyster, they had to bring up some sand to prove that they'd actually dived down to the bottom. Children were very good at it, and pregnant women. They thought pregnant women could hold their breath for a lot longer. Then they got the gear, the hard hats, the suits, and the Japanese just had the best technique picking them up, and they were fearless as well. It was a very dangerous job. You could jump in, you'd go straight down, you'd have like 100 pounds worth of weight on you, and you go straight down, you can break your knees, your legs, you get dragged along the ocean floor, but the Japanese had no fear. And that continued till about 1969, same year that man walked on the moon. They were still using that old equipment, still doing the same sort of thing, but then new techniques came in, like the wetsuits, and instead of using an air compressor, using the tanks as well, so it kind of just slowly phased out. But it was only like 40, 50 years ago that they were still doing the same thing. Lots of people think it was about, 100 years ago, but it was, up to 1970, that's how they did it, yeah. Obviously, people are more clued up in terms of the bends. Lots of people died of the bends. People would smoke opium to stop them from going to the toilet in their suits. Then it was interested in that. And they'd have a little bottle, and that was their pee bottle in their suit, and they'd go to the toilet. They'd be down there for hours till they had enough shell. The shell would be sent up to the top and then emptied, send the basket back down. First of all, it's the tides, and the food up here is what the oysters live on. And also, there is a continental shelf, which is where the bigger oysters, when they first got collected 100 years ago, just for the shell, pearls were just a bit of a bonus. There were lots of oysters in those continental shelves, so they were found naturally here. The warm temperature, so it encourages the growth, and it also encourages the oysters to produce the nacre and make the pearls, so that's why it works up here. The main thing is the oysters are found here naturally. Leftover pearl shell, you can use that for paints, instrument inlay, furniture inlay, knife and fork handles, buttons. That was the main reason for starting this industry. The pearls, they're all different sizes, shapes, colours. When they're all lined up in the showroom, it's very clear to see the slightest different shade of white or silver, especially in the strands, like when they're all lined up together and you can actually point out the different sizes and the shapes. I just love pearls. I didn't know anything about pearls until I came here. I've been here for 2 years now, and it's probably the only thing I'll ever wear now. Because I live, eat, sleep, pearls.